Good morning, my dear students. Today we are going to see the new syllabus of our board examination. ICSE board renewed the syllabus because of this corona pandemic. I think you all are aware about this. Anyway, for short stories, we got the chapters from 1 to 10 except chapter 8. For your final examination, we don't have chapter 8, the blue beat. Rest all chapters are coming for your examination. So altogether we go to 9 chapters. And before our quarterly examination, we completed all our syllabus for a better revision. Because of that, we are going to start our revision from chapter 1. We will see the brief summary of the chapter and also about the important points that we want to keep in mind. Dear students, I heard that some students are saying already the first 6 chapters we learned for our 9th class board examination, so that there won't be any questions from that part. We only want to learn chapters from 7, 8, 9 and 10. But it is a wrong thing. If we go through our previous year's question papers, we can easily find out lot of questions from all the chapters. So that we want to learn all the chapters in detail. So the chapters for your final examination is Chief Sadler's Speech, Old Man at the Bridge, A Horse and Two Gods, Hearts and Hands, A Face in the Dark, An Angel in Disguise, The Little Match Girl, My Greatest Olympic Prize, and All Summer in a Day. We will start our revisions from the first chapter, Chief Sadler's Speech. So dear students, we will start with the revision of chapter 1, Chief Sadler's Speech. Sadler was born around 1780 near Blake Island, Washington. Sadler earned his reputation at a young age as a leader and a warrior. He achieved this reputation by ambushing and defeating groups of tribal enemies. Like many of his contemporaries, he owned slaves captured during his raids. He was very tall and bold person. He was nearly 6 feet tall. He was also known as an orator, and when he addressed an audience, his voice was loud and bold. For all his skill, Sadler was gradually losing ground to the more powerful persons when white settlers started showing up in force around 1850. The white settlers came there and started to settle down there. That time, these tribal people lost their power. Not only their power, but also their traditions and beliefs. The settlement of white people affected their life. Chief Sadler noticed that his people were driven from their traditional climbing grounds, the land which they born and brought up. Because of that, he met Doc Minard in Olympia, and they formed a friendly relationship useful to both. This friendship helped them to establish a strong relationship, and both of them supported each other, especially Minard's support for Chief Sadler's people, and negotiated relatively peaceful relations with the tribes. When the white people started to settle down in Chief Sadler's land, that made a lot of difficulties for his tribe people. They felt like their land and their tradition is vanishing from their life. It is a speech delivered in 1854 by Chief Sadler, who belonged to Suquamish tribe. He delivered this speech at Washington, and in this speech he pursued the path of accommodation to white settlers in the US state of Washington. His speech contains arguments in favor of ecological responsibility and respect of Native Americans' land rights. Chief Sadler is calling his children as red children in this speech. In his speech, he is recollecting the hostilities that existed between the white and his tribal people. He thinks that his old tribal people will never like to resume the old hostilities. He hopes that their good father in Washington would protect them. he realized that the white man and the red children are two distinct races. There is little common in them. He refers to the propositions received from the white man. He thinks that the propositions seem to be fair and his people will accept it. But he puts a condition before they take a decision. He says that his people will be free to visit the tombs of their ancestors, friends, and children at any time. He opines that the deserted streets at night will be filled with the returning host that once filled them and still love this beautiful land. This is what Chief Sattel is trying to speak to his tribe people. In this chapter, we will see Chief Sattel delivers a speech at Washington in 1854. And in this speech, he thanks the white chief for the acknowledgement of his greetings of friendship and goodwill. He speaks in favor of ecological responsibility and respect of Native Americans' land rights. And also he offers greetings of friendship to the white people. Throughout his speech, he is speaking about the protection of his tribe. He wants his tribe people to be protected by the white people. And in the end of the speech, we will see Chief Sattel's appeals to the white people to be just and kind to his tribe people. This is a brief discussion about the author and also about the story. Theme and summary of the chapter we will see in the next revision class. Thank you.